nation, what others are doing, you are doing it. The way they dress, you dress alike. The way they talk, you talk alike. You are not different from them, not the nation. You are just like them. There is nothing you tell them that they will take from you. But you are talking about making jest of you because why? We all come together. Everything I'm supposed is not as a woman on a mission, it's not everywhere you go. It's not everybody you mingle with. I'm not saying to the enemies, no. The people you love from distance doesn't mean you hate them. Hello, hello, it doesn't mean you hate them. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
There's something I wrote down here. I said, women on assignment from God, they are careful the way they live their lives. They are very, very careful the way they live their lives. Because they are mirrors. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And they are worthy to be emulated. People want to live like this. You see that woman. Everybody wants to make example. You know, see this sister, the way she lives her life. But I say character speaks first. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
There are things you don't see. As Mama was saying just now, on Sunday you come to the house of God, you know, but on Saturday we are like, on Friday we are with you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Some see it as if you are in Europe, it doesn't matter. On Friday, you'll be in the school theater. You'll be dancing. After drinking alcohol, after just the one day music, also you want to raise up your hand to God. My husband will say something. He said, if you're a choir, you don't live right with God. Your praise and worship does not pass. That is the truth.
Hallelujah.
You might be in the choir, maybe it's only one person, maybe 50 people will be in the choir, maybe it's only one person's voice that God is hearing. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
May we not be that type in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us live life that God will see of the truth. This is a woman of God.
Hallelujah.
Of the truth. That sister really know God.
Hallelujah.
She knows what she's doing.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
There are 3 points I pick out as a woman on assignment that I want to let us know today. One, distraction. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
For many today are easily distracted. I'm in a church, or I'm in a fellowship like this now. Ah, sister, so exalted us. Now, we should go to talk to Daniel. Now, we should go to talk to her. We should take preach. No. A message. If somebody says, I use and preach, yes, a message is for somebody. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If somebody uses you to preach, that message is for you. It's for you to change your ways. That's how that message came. Definitely, somebody uses you to preach. If you see, if you make it that way, it's for you. For a turnaround, it will check your ways.
Hallelujah.
Am I living right with God? What kind of life am I living? You check it and say, no, this is not an answer. This is not how I'm supposed to live. You walk away and live a perfect life with God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But perfection is not possible. Everybody is perfect. Yes. If the Bible says it is perfect, if God is perfect, say you are God on earth, we too can be perfect. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
What kind of life are we living? Are you the type that come to church on Sunday, rest of your events, weekends, you are somewhere else? Praise the Lord. Today, like in my church, I don't know about other churches, when they come with weekly activities, I will be surprised. We will not see more than 3 or 4 women. Maybe in total, will be, if we are too much, we'll be 10. Where are the rest? On Sunday, the church will just get filled up to the end. Where are the rest? It is an error. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
But when they say there is passing for a corner now, even if they are sure, maybe they send it for 30 years. The overall, nearly everybody will have it. What an error. But in the days of God today, when they ask her to come and sow seed, that people will start to talk. Hey, touch your legacy. But they forget the church, the parentage. Light bill is there. Water bill is there. Nobody talks about that. It's also money that they ask. The place you come to sit down, they don't pay the bill. Where will you sit? Praise the Lord. Where will you worship? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I'm talking of my number one thing today. I say focus. That is, let us not be distracted. Let us stay focused. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'll take us to the book of Matthew 15. Matthew 15:8. Then you want to live Europe life now, Europe will be. Then Europe cannot serve God. What are they? It's not only Africa they serve you, they serve God. No. They are swear serving in Europe. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He said, these people draw near unto me with their mouths and honor me with their lips.
Mm.
But in their hearts, they are far from me. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You see, today, we don't show up. We do show up. That way, some people, they will say they know God when Mr. A is there. Because they know where they meet. They will change their ways. They will not say what they are supposed to say because they don't get the meat. In the church, they will shout, hallelujah. When Master is speaking, they will have the loudest hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us not be that type. At least have our lives, but deep down in our heart, they have something. That will be our portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Also, the book of Matthew 14, I'll take it from 22. It's a bit long. And Jesus straight away, Jesus constrained his disciples to get into the ship and go before him onto the other side. While he sent his multitudes away, and when he had sent his multitudes away, he went up into a mountain apart to pray. And when the evening was come, he was there alone, but the ship was not in the midst of the sea, tossed with waves, for the wind was contrary. And in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went unto them, walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, it is a spirit. They cried out for fear. But straight away, this is where I want to talk about. But straight away, Jesus spake unto them, saying, be of good cheer, it is I, be not afraid. And Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it be thou, bid me come unto thee on the water. And he said, come. When Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But when he saw the wind was stirring, he was afraid and began to sink. He cried, saying, Lord, save me. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That is how it is very opposed to you. Initially, we look unto Jesus, who is the bottom and the finisher of our faith. Because of little thing, we get discouraged and begin to sink. That's what happens here. When they saw Jesus walking on the water, I said, God, I want to come. When he initially was walking on it, but later on he looked back and was afraid because of the posterior thing, what happened, he began to sink.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But we stay focused. No matter the ups and downs, no matter what you are going through, the Lord does not forsake his home.
At all. Hallelujah.
No matter what, he does not forsake his home.
Amen.
Stand firm with his own.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We will not be distracted. May the Lord help us to stay strong in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And always look unto Jesus.
Amen.
Because he does not forsake his name. There must, yes, temptation will come. Temptation will show up. Whenever I promise God that there will be no temptation, temptation will come. But how do you stand it? How do you stand temptation when it comes? That is how you know a true child of God.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
With the word of God, we will overcome temptation.
Amen.
With the Lord, when you know the God you serve, nothing will shake you.
Mm.
That way will shock you.
That's right.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
And the end will be victorious and testify to the glory of God.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because of the book of Acts 10:38-42, talking of focus. Take it from 38-42, you know the story. Acts 10, I'm taking it from 38:42. And it came to pass as they went that he entered into a certain village, and a certain woman named Martha received him into her house. And she had a sister called Mary, which also sat at Jesus' feet and heard his word. But Martha was scorned about much serving, and came to him and said, Lord, thou art not cared that my sister had left me to serve alone. Be that therefore that she helped me. And Jesus answered and said unto her, Martha, Martha, thou art careful and troubled about many things. But one thing is needful, and Mary hath chosen that good part which shall not be taken away from her. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We that is yet to be chosen the good part.
Amen. Hallelujah.
We that are yet to be chosen the good part.
Amen.
When you go out there today, many are just busy doing nothing. That was what Mary was doing. Sorry, all that matter was doing. She was busy doing nothing. Some of us today will be in the house, but the pastor is preaching with the asset. Some will be gossiping right inside the church. Some will be, this one dressed, soon as she did, it never much. Right inside the church, you never stay focused. You'll be looking at what people are doing. Some are finding faults. And sisters, being sure you speak their work already. Hey, which can speak? We'll be finding for us to stay focused and listen, pick a word that God has sent the man of God to give to me that day. So we'll be busy doing nothing. These days, I said this is too much in the house of God. I said this. When pastor is there, different character. When pastor is not there, different character. Why don't you be yourself? Because for me, I don't go to church to serve men. I go to church to serve God. When I see the entity strong, I'll say, take it or leave it. Even if you hate me tomorrow, no problem. But I will say the truth. And the truth, that same truth has set me free. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I beg God, sisters, let us stay focused. That no matter what is happening around us, don't give up.
Amen.
This town we are is a land of distraction.
That's right.
People want to distract you. Why do they go to church? Because they go to church, you know, they don't see church. Church. You go. Let them see. The end will tell.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The end will tell.
Amen.
The end will tell. People want to bring this anger that you've forgotten in you. Just stand up and say, God, I have left this city. I don't want to go back to it.
Amen.
No matter what they do, stay strong. Throughout the night, at about 3, I don't know if my it's just my life that I don't know. As long as it's 2, I'm ready up. I'll just pray throughout that night, like, go through the Bible, and just like that. Every night, you know, about 5, 6, that's when I'll start to sleep. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But I know God is up to something.
That's
praise
right.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So I'll beg us, let us not be that type that run after things of the world. That run after things of the world. Let us be that type that run after things of the world. Like me today, I don't feel the bad part here. No. After church service, if they go inside the church, I'm okay. Outside the church, I don't know. When I'm there, I'm not comfortable. There's this thing in me. I'll be thinking about it for a very long time. Why is it that when I go to the party, I'm not ever comfortable? Why? I know God is a bad place to me.
Amen.
But there's not every place you go to. I choose where I go to.
That's right.
I choose where I go to. I don't know if people are going there for me to please whoever is doing anything. No. That's why I'm not saying you are the best. You don't come my party. This is the wrong verse. You the best, no verse. I don't have any reason. I won't lie. I don't have any reason. It's 2 things. And I hate to take my children in party. They'll start running up and I say party. No. I don't like it. I don't take my children to parties. Where adults are sitting down. They will start running up and down. Baby, you want this one. Which can be kicked with this? I'm not saying my children are the best. No. I want them, they are
where
my children to grow up.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
I want them to live that kind of life. I don't have anybody to live there. Maybe it's a place I would love to go. So let me just live for a few minutes. If I don't have anybody to live there for, I will not go. I will stay back. I don't like the idea. You take my children to party, go over there, they drink alcohol. Because children, they learn fast.
Yes, ma'am. They learn very fast.
They learn very fast. You think they don't know what they are doing. Questions they will be asking you. Be surprised. What they see, they easily imitate people. What they see, these are things that I let my children look certain things. I don't think they're not to lie. Mommy, why is this thing like this? That's when the time comes, you know. You understand? Sometimes there was a child in my class in the church. She asked me a question. Then it was during the we're teaching them the 10 commandments. What happened? What was the child asking me? She said, thou shalt not lie. Thou shalt not. You violate this law straight to heaven. She asked me a question. Auntie, sometimes what they will call my mother, she doesn't want to. She asked me to be before and tell her or him that she's not around. I say no. Tell her mommy is a lie. If you don't want to talk, just keep your phone. Leave it. Whenever you want to talk to the person, you call the person. He said that my mommy will beat me. I said, tell her your teacher said. He said, no, auntie, my mommy will beat me. I said, tell her your teacher said, that is how you train a child.
Hallelujah.
Tomorrow, you better tell them it's a lie. Lie is lie. They're going to polish it. That is that.
I hear you.
Say, no, it doesn't matter. It matters. It matters. Because these children, when they grow up, they say they go to school, they will learn. You as a parent, it starts from you. Not from the church. Not from the church. A man, one time, somebody was telling me, and my children don't know how to pray. And you know, I want to teach them how to pray. I said, sir, how many times do they have at the church? Only on Sunday, maybe 2 or 3 hours. Teach them how to pray in your house.
Hallelujah.
Not in the church. You know, to the little we can. It's just to make you be kind. You can't do all for you. No. You understand? It's just many are not privileged, we know. The one we can do, we will do and leave the rest for you parents. It all starts at home.
Hallelujah.
Not in the church, not in the streets. No, it all starts at home. The way you take care of your children matters a lot. At home, you will not cry.
Praise Amen. The Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You know, look at people, I will laugh. Me, I have one God. It's me that gave child a better my children. Yes. But everybody have the right to take care of their phone.
Hallelujah.
When they are doing wrong.
That's right.
I'm never angry about it. So my children, they cannot come home and tell me in the church or somebody who called me in the class, what did you do? Because your teacher cannot just look at you and flog you. There must be something you did. Praise the Lord. What did you do? Tell me what you did. When they will start talking, because I was making, maybe you're supposed to make notes while you're in the class. You're not supposed to make notes while you're in the class. They will like, they don't report again. When they come home, their father will say, how dare you say that? But I know, you know, they will just like, they beat my king. Why you go touch my king? Why you go correct him at all? No, I don't play with my children, eh? No, I don't play with my children, eh? In future, you play with them. In future, you play with them.
Hallelujah.
If some men will say, well, their body language will tell you that they are not happy to talk to their child. What are they? Some say they are in Europe. Now, Europe, they did. Now, Europe children, no. I'm happy where I came out from Africa. They taught us in a hard way. Today they are enjoying it.
That's right. Yes.
Many of us, because those days, I remember I lived in a big company. You know how we grew up in a big company, everybody, neighbors. My parents were not there. So that is when I say my father was a very disciplined man. When I say my parents were not there, sometimes the day you take your results. There's an uncle and auntie waiting for you at the door, in the compound. All of you come and line up. Oh yeah, here's your report card. The beating they will give you, it will be as if it's your parents that are beating you. Praise the Lord. But today, your children is not like that. But they love them inside house. Many children are spoiled. May the Lord help us in Jesus'
name. Amen.
So they will catch you for truths inside that. They carry along the children. Was you catch you for truths? Is that what is going to make them better children? No, there's a lot.
Holy Ghost troops.
There is a lot to it. It says, spare the rod and spoil the child.
Hallelujah.
When you spare the rod, you spoil it. I flog my children. I flog them. The social problem on them, your son, or the second one is an apple. He said, flog. I said, in Africa, that's not going to be good. When they live right, no problem. When they sometimes they do things that are not so bad, smart them. I do. I don't pamper my children. No, when there's time for everything.
That's right.
When it comes to pamper them, you pamper them. But to a limit. And then we'll not get. Teach them, let them know. The last boy in my house, arrange his bed. Go arrange it. They'll say, there are no girls in my home. My children, they are boys that they cook well.
Very well.
Say, they are no girls. The God that they will not do nothing, they will do. Let them, the way you teach them matters.
Hallelujah.
I'm already distracted because I'm talking on focus.
Yes, sir.
May the Lord help us in Jesus'
name. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And the second I'm talking on is pride. That's eating deep today in the church. Pride. That's eating deep in the church today. You see, a woman that believed that a good Bible, before you know, they mistakenly give he or she title. Nobody's not to have a problem with you. When you talk, who you talk to, because I have been whatever in the church. It's an error. Mm. It is an error. Even people are not in the congregation, who notice your title? You look at your title along the streets. No, it's inside the church then.
Amen.
Let us learn not to be proud to each other. Mm. Not be proud about nothing. You came with, you don't know this type of nothing, and I'm not going with anything. Mm. You see, exhaust the one. Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I pray the Lord with us.
Amen.
I'll take the book of James 4, 6, the popular verse. James chapter 4, verse 6.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Say the wise woman, Proverb, beautiful.
And the foolish.
And the foolish one will pluck it down. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You don't believe in him. And people you associate with matters a lot. That's how that is what will take you far. You follow those that have nothing to deliver, my sister, you are on your own. At the end, you will look for tears.
You will not find one.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And even if you believe that they are your own, that they will still be the ones. They will narrate you around the Pamplona. This is that. She'll never wait. Let's say, finish the story. She have the person to analyze it. Might happen. I did not happen. They will have to analyze. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
May the Lord help us.
Amen.
To stay focused.
Amen.
That no matter what we are going through, we should not be distracted.
Amen.
And help us to know who and who we should. If we want to take that who and who that we should follow, praise the Lord. I told you, I will not read it because of time. 1 Corinthians 15:33, Proverbs 13:20, Proverbs 14:7, Psalm 26:4-5. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And the Lord help us read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord Jesus. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. In Jesus' name. This is glorious, beautiful. I know if you have given that time, she will just, nobody now, we already know that, so God will. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. It is holy to regret today. Multiply and fill the earth and subdue it. Be masters over the birds of the birds and over all the animals. And God said, look, I have given this, I have given thee the seed bearing plant throughout the earth, and all the fruit of the tree for food. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I want to stop there. When you don't know yourself, people will tell you who you are. When you don't know yourself, people will tell you who you are not. Praise Master Jesus. This is what we read from the book of Genesis. The first kingdom of human revelation was a new beginning. And the new beginning, I will liken it to the Bible, when God stepped into the earth. It was a new beginning for the earth. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And the second program was the decree must change. Praise the Lord. And the second thing that God did when he stepped into the earth, coming to the earth, I said it's a new beginning. For the earth to experience a living being on the face of the earth. When God stepped into the earth, when it was in time form and body. And for God to begin to work, he has to change the decree. And when he changed the decree, we said the ruling force on that on the earth at that time was darkness all over the earth, was water everywhere, and it was void and empty, there was nothing. And God began to create and create and create. And when he changed the decree, the ruling forces first, then he now began to create things. And we have already done that. And when he finished doing that, he looked around and saw that the earth was full. Everything in it was beautiful. But he realized that there was something that was out of place. Hallelujah. And what was out of place was man. Praise the Lord. Was a woman was out of place. A man and a woman was out of place. And he said to himself, let us now make man. Who was talking to? God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost inside him. Let us make man. Praise Master Jesus. That is why I have come to tell you, you are not an error. You are plant. You know, there are some people that say this baby was not, it was an unwanted baby, it was an accident baby. Nobody is an accident child. Nobody is an accident woman. Nobody is an accident man. You are divinely planned and divinely structured by God to fulfill a purpose. But you cannot fulfill that purpose if you cannot discover yourself. I said for you to discover yourself, who is your father? My name is Adesuwa Igori, and Igori is my surname. So that is my father's name. Praise the Lord. And nobody can tell me this is my father because I know my father. So for you to function as a woman on a mission, you cannot help others when you don't know your father. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I pray God help me today.
Amen.
I said the word means that the word discover means to find out about something. To find out some information. It means to see, to get knowledge. To learn, to gain insight, to discover. Woman, discover yourself. When God looks, he has finished everything. He said, now let me make man. Women on the mission will not be successful if you that is on the mission do not know yourself. Praise Master Jesus. You see, our sister told us in the first place, when you are going to church to praise God, on Friday, Saturday, you are in the world to praise the world. So you don't know yourself. But if you know yourself, you will stand firm. Praise Master Jesus. He said, let us make man in our own image. Woman, you are made in the copy of God. Image means something, a copy of something. Image, a copy of something. Praise Master Jesus. The word is a copy of something or a form of a picture or statue. That is an image. You are image of God. Praise the Lord. And what likeness means to be similar to God. So you are woman, you are similar to God. Praise Master Jesus. You have a similar character with God. Praise Master Jesus. That is what the woman he created was. And that is who you are if only you discover yourself. Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
I said as a woman on a mission, you must discover yourself after you have first been offered a new beginning and later the decree was changed. And now you must discover yourself. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In order for you to minister to others, a woman on the mission, a woman on assignment, for you to be able to faithfully carry out this assignment, you must discover yourself. What do I have in my inside to offer others? What am I called to do? Who is my father? What has he said to me? What is he expecting me to do? You must discover yourself. Praise Master Jesus. And that's here, I said, who are you? And whose you are? A snake does not give birth to a lizard. If you claim that you are born of God, then why are you still behaving like a lizard? A snake does not give birth to a lizard. Hallelujah. So, woman, discover yourself. Let people, if you don't discover yourself, people will tell you who you are and who you are not. Praise Master Jesus. God said, let us make man.
Somebody they come out.
Spanish. To be master. To be master over all. What? To be master over all. Praise the Lord. First, you being an image of God, God has endowed you with a creative ability as a woman. He has empowered you with creative ability as a woman. So when he said, let me make man in my own image and in my own likeness, as a copy of God, he has made you with a creative power. Praise the Lord. So you have no reason to be idle. When he mentioned, said, nobody, God has not created anybody empty. Everyone has a measure of something in his inside. But the reason why you are still where you are is because you have not discovered yourself. Hallelujah. As a woman, discover yourself. For this group, to go to the next level, I must discover myself because there are so much in my inside. Hallelujah. Amen. My mentor always tells me, I know she's online now, and I pray God bless her because she's on her knees. And I praise the Lord. Evangelist Toye Shopatusi, and so many others praying for us. Hallelujah. God has created you with a creative ability to make a change and to make a difference in your environment. Praise the Lord. But it's so unfortunate today that we, the children of God, that claims to be, many a times our creative ability is not glorifying or bringing honor to God. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. I said here, he has given us creative ability to stand and to bring things, to stand even in the face of uncertainty. You know, when God stepped into the terrain, the Bible said it was void. It was without what? It was without form. It was dark. There was water everywhere. So he stepped in and began to put things in place. Woman, when you discover yourself, you will know that you are a helper. You are not a helmet, but you are a helpmate. You are not a helmet. Anyway, you step in, solution is supposed to come if only you discover yourself. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And he said here again, he said, let us make them in our likeness. Woman, not until you discover that you are a master. I am not saying master over your husband, but you are master over a situation that rises up. Anywhere you find yourself, you cannot make impact in the life of others. Praise Master Jesus. He said, you have pattern after God. God was not overwhelmed by a situation that came when he stepped into the earth. When he saw the way it was, he was not overwhelmed. But he looked and said, what do I do? Let there be light. Praise the Lord. So you are pattern to be master, not master over your husband, as you know, he's giving us the hope. But master over situations that may arise, or blessed ones that may arise, that you be master over them, to dominate and not let the problem overwhelm you. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And when God is talking to us, you are a master. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And later again, when we continue from there, he said he blessed them. When he means blessing, physically, spiritually, financially, materially, in all ramifications of life, woman, you are blessed. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Woman, you are blessed. If only you discover yourself, you are blessed. Physically, things might not be working the way it's supposed to work. But listen, the eyes you have is not only to see the physical, but it's to see beyond the physical. That is why I said, woman, discover yourself. I was praying, I said, God, what do I have to say? What do I have to teach? Put your word in my mouth. I don't want to. My mentor was teaching the other day. He said, have a purposeful gathering. And I cannot teach from that word, purposeful, 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 purposeful. Have something. Let it be tangible. Let it be meaningful. And I began to pray. I said, God, what do I have? Put a word in my mouth. Now, one of the days, immediately I finished praying, prayers, I just picked up my Bible. And this word just came, woman, discover yourself. I sat for a woman discovered myself. Then the thing just took me to Genesis 1, 26. And as I began to read, I read from 26 to 30, and the inspiration that I was just writing. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. Woman, you are blessed by God. I don't know the situation that you have found yourself. Maybe physically you don't have money. Maybe physically you are not with a child. Maybe physically you don't have a job. Maybe physically you don't have a husband. You don't have anything. But maybe you are blessed.
Amen.
When you settle it within yourself, because right, that is why I said, woman, discover yourself. You cannot discover yourself with one. For you to discover yourself, you must know who is your father. So what? You don't know your father. You don't know what your father stands for. You don't even have basis. You can't do anything. But listen, I am talking to the woman that God wants, he or them, that wants her to discover herself, that she is blessed of the Lord. Physically, spiritually, materially, she is blessed. This fellow is blessed. Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
You are not cursed, you are blessed. It might be that you are believing God for a child, but the Bible says you are blessed.
Amen.
You might be believing God for financial breakthrough. God says you are blessed.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. God blesses somebody now. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And he says here, he said multiply. In fashion, woman, you are fashioned to multiply. You are fashioned to reproduce. Hallelujah. Not only your biological children, but to bring children with impact. As my mama was talking to us, he said, now, she was telling us just now, many people choose mentor, many people choose people for just one reason or another. And somebody told her, I want this woman to be like God, but she knows how to dress. She uses gold and decorates herself very well. She's pretty. Praise the Lord. That one has just been, she's just been in her own ministry. But listen, as a woman, God has given you the ability to reproduce your own kind, not only your biological children, but your own spiritual children for him. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So you have the grace to multiply and to fill the earth. Hallelujah. How do you multiply and fill the earth? Praise the Lord. You are not a mother because you have children. You multiply, how do you multiply to fill the earth? Through your character. Let people see you and emulate you. Let people see you and copy you. I just want to be like this person. I just want to be simple. I just want to make impact for God. I just want to serve God. Hallelujah. Your purpose. Discover. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It says occupy. When it means fill, it means occupy the space. Pamplona is weak. But this is the first time this kind of thing is happening. Hallelujah. But I just dare to be different because I have discovered that there is something in my inside that I need to reproduce before I leave this land. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I need to pass on before I leave this land. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I pray God is going to help us all to do it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Then he said here again, after he has blessed you, he gave you the ability to subdue. What is subdue? To bring under control, to tame, rule and reign over them. Not there to rule over you. Hallelujah. Not there to rule over you. A servant does not rule over the master. Everything we see upon the face of the earth, they are to answer to us, but not we to answer to them. So God has led you to subdue, to rule. If only you discover yourself. You want to make impact. You want the four corners of the earth to hear your voice. Then you must discover yourself. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let nobody tell you you are nobody. Let nobody. The Bible says a man's worth is not determined by what he has. A man is not defined by what he has. Praise the Lord. Let nobody tell you you are poor, you are rich. Let nobody tell you you have nothing to show for all your services. But listen and listen very well. You have given the power to subdue, to bring under control, to subject everything. Because God has made you the master. If only you know you are the boss, not boss over your husband, but boss over everyone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I called here, I said, you are a helper. Amen. You are a second in command. If only you will discover this, that this is who you are, you'll be able to fulfill purpose. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Listen, you might tell me now, man, you don't understand me. I am living from hand to mouth. My belly feed. My teeth are not working. Listen to me. A slave today will become a man tomorrow. A man today is going to become somebody great tomorrow. I remember there was a time I was living with people, but today I live on my own. Hallelujah. So listen and listen very good. You are blessed.
Amen.
He has made you the head.
Amen.
Let the situation confine you to the truth, to the fact they are telling you that there is nothing. You that is even living with somebody, you that is feeding, you could barely feed, you cannot even wear clothes, you cannot do this. Listen and listen good. What did your father say? You
are blessed.
Somebody can bring you up with his mouth and bring you down with his mouth. Somebody can talk you to and fro. Somebody can do one or two things just because when you don't know yourself, people will tell you who you are not. At times, people will tell you, they make you to believe who you are not. I said some time ago, I believe in this meeting, there was a particular situation of my life I was at a particular time many, many, many years ago. All I could hear was, you are good for nothing. You are good for nothing. You are good for nothing. Even when I would travel the other time, I was sharing with my cousin. I was sharing with my auntie. I said, auntie, you remember so telling me, you are good for nothing. That was what I was hearing. I was hearing day and night. And it became because I could not respond. I accepted it. I saw myself as good for nothing. I struggled with compassion. I looked around and said, yes, I am good for nothing. But the truth is, I did not know the Bible. Then I was not a Christian. There are some people on my platform that are witness to this. I sit down and I cry. God, is this how I'm just going to waste away? God, is it true that I am good for nothing? God, is this how my life is? I could barely eat. I'm not telling somebody's story, my own story. And I know God is taking me somewhere. That is why I believe this mission is on women on the mission. I never believed in myself. I never ever believed that something good was going to come out of me because it was a constant hearing on my ears. Praise the Lord. But the day I discovered that I was made in the image and the likeness of God, and after he had finished, my Bible said he blessed. Because I have discovered that it was my ignorance that has been giving my adversaries upper hand over me. I could not stop when those words were coming. But when I discovered myself, when the word is coming, in fact, the word does not come anymore. As they are about to, I bring a word and I return it back to sender.
Amen.
Yes. After challenging first, second, that word. And I bless God for my husband, who made it possible that God has been using another people to tell me there is something in your inside. There is something in your inside. You are good. You are good enough. You are good. Praise Master Jesus. So when you have not discovered yourself, you will just look that you don't have anything to offer. My mentor said, is it to every man God has given something to offer? And the world is waiting for your earnest. The world is waiting for you to manifest. But if only you can discover yourself and not allow that situation you are not to pain you and let you know that you are not worthy. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Some time ago, a man of God walked up to me and said, that was 2 years ago, 3 years ago. He said, man, the Lord said it is time. But you are seated saying, not until this thing happened, you will do this one. And I told you, I said, yes, sir. Because where is my testimony? Where is my testimony? But when after he finished talking, I said, sir, 2 days ago, I sat down and I was thinking, ringing my head. Then my mentor came into my life and she said, listen, why you are saying where is your testimony? Keep running and let them begin to see the testimonies. Hallelujah. And to the glory of God, God is doing something. I don't know how I find myself here, but anytime I stand here, I stand with confidence. This is somebody that says, that the word says, okay, you are good for will you discover, how can you discover yourself? You, a child that does not have a good relationship with the father does not benefit from his father. So, woman, if you must discover yourself, you must go back to your father. Your father is not Igori. Your father is God. Just that Igori is the channel where God brought me through to this earth. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Your father is not your father. The father I'm talking about is not the one that gave birth to you. That is just a channel. Praise the Lord. But the one that is your father is the maker of heaven and earth. The one that looked around and saw everything was beautiful and said it will be useless when you are not involved. So that is why I said you are just too important and too relevant to allow the things of this world to just maneuver their way into your life and take hold of you and make you to lose your sense and lose your mind. He looked around after he has finished everything. He said, look, victory, without victory upon this planet earth, it is not good enough. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Value yourself. If you discover yourself, you will place value on yourself. I don't beg people to do something. No. If you want to do, we do. Because in it is your reward. We do. You know, he looks at me that I am so precious. After he had finished everything, he looked and said, it is not good until I step in, until they brought me into the picture. Man, you are brought into a picture for a purpose. Why not sit down and discover yourself? I don't want the trouble. That thing that is just constantly reminding you of who you are. It's constantly telling you we are not seeing the result. It's constantly telling you you are good for nothing. It's constantly telling you, listen, is anything good going to come up from you? Go back to your father, the author of life, and look at him and say, Father, what are you saying? Let me tell you, he said, you are his. If that's only the word I'm going to talk about today. You are blessed.
Amen.
Woman, for you to absolutely succeed in the mission that God has placed you in your home. In this land, Babylon, you didn't come to Babylon because there is a youth here. There are helps here. No, God brought you here for a divine purpose. Just because you have not been able to discover the purpose that God has brought you here. That is why you are pursuing government. In fact, government sees you on the road. You are pursuing them to and fro. You are chasing them. But when you discover yourself, then you will know that your help is not from the government, but it's from the maker of heaven and earth.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Is God talking to somebody today?
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Mama talked about Deborah. Deborah was the wife of Lapid. In the book of Judges, praise the Lord. She was the wife of Lapid. She discovered herself that she's not only a wife, only to this man, and a mother to these children that God has given to me. But this thing that God has placed in my inside is so much that I can give it out. And she began to spread her good works. She did not only become a judge, she became a mother in Israel. Not only a mother in Israel, she went with men to war. Listen, woman, when you discover yourself, men will want to have you in their meeting. Men, that is what the Bible gave to us. Men of war stood. Men that have fought war before stood. They said, we will not go, Deborah, if you don't go with us. Deborah said, okay, let it be known today that it is true in God brought victory. Woman, when you discover yourself, men will want to seek counsel from you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Men and women will want to seek counsel from you. You will be a woman sought for. Hallelujah. Esther discovered that she was not only a queen in the palace, but she realized that she was to solve some problems. You know, when the book of Esther, when Mordecai began to say, Esther, when this thing happened, Esther chapter 4, when they don't think you will be saved, if you don't want to help us, this is that, that. But she did not respond. It was one word that made her head, that made her discover herself. What was that word? Mordecai said, who knows? For such a reason, for such a purpose, you were queen. You are a queen at this time. Who knows if it is for such a time that God has brought a queen. Ha! Woman, I am here to tell you, you are in this room not because we have food to offer you, not because we have drinks to offer you, but you are in this room because God has a greater picture for you. God has a greater plan for you.
Amen.
God has a reason of bringing you to Pamplona.
Amen.
Pamplona.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
And for you, when you discover yourself, you will now understand that there are some things that are irrelevant. Mama was saying some certain things yesterday. I do makeup. At times I go out to family. I go to church with family. I do so many things. But I don't make it a do or die for her. Praise
yes.
the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And she said something that so impressed me today. That today, many of us, which is very true, children of God, will run after the Ashwebi stuff. If I tell them that women on the mission, everybody come with yellow attire, black skirts, you see this place will be full. Everybody wants to come and tell me there is Ashoke, there is beaded, there is thin, everybody wants to display their attire. Praise the Lord. But to the women on the mission, when you discover yourself, you know that there are important things and there are irrelevant things. You don't waste your time and your energy for things that profit them nothing.
Yes.
When you discover yourself, you don't run after things that make no sense. I don't run because people are running. I don't do things because people are doing. I do when I feel I am
doing.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I want to tell you a story that I heard many years ago in the church about an eagle. This eagle was grown up with a bird from its very tender age as a bird. And they were all growing, and they were all growing together. Each time, you know, hen, they fly, now they fly out of the tree. So eagle will also fly, want to fly higher. You see the bird, they begin to laugh and laugh and laugh and laugh. Look, in our family, we don't fly higher. Where we fly to the treetop. That is all. The eagle began to walk with them. But as time begins to go, the eagle discovered that there was so many differences between the eagle and the hen. When he looked at his peak, his own peak, his paw. And the hen's on the street. The hen with that family, he began to look at his collar. He began to look at his foot. He began to look at his manners. Sisters, we are here today. I want you to begin to check yourself. For you to discover yourself, you must know your father. You must know what your father wants you to do. You must know the love that binds your home. Because the Bible says, train up a child. So you must be trained by your father. And when you are trained by your father, before you go out of making parts, then you must work on your circle of influence. Praise the Lord, your association. The eagle began to look. I was telling somebody some time ago, I said, I've been in Europe, I came to Europe very long. I said, Bet, do you know, home and abroad, I've gone to a discotheque twice. And somebody asked me, he said, what kind of life have you lived now? Even before you became a Christian, you did not live well. And now you are even a Christian, I'm seeing that it's like hell. You are just in bondage. I said, no, I'm not in bondage. You are in doubt. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Because I never liked it. It's not my style. It has not been my calling. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And the eagle gradually will look. How are we not the same? Yes, we go to the same church. I want to relate it to us. The fact we go to the same church, we tie the same hair. But there is something in my inside that is telling me I'm different. Praise the Lord. There is something constantly convincing me that we are not on the same pathway. Praise the Lord. And this ego began. So each time the ego flies, you see the birds, they begin to laugh. Bird, they even gave him a name. Bird pig, calm down. Your pig is bird. Come, we don't fly in our family. And the ego, only to them that he was only exercising his wings. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Gradually, he kept on. Sisters, I want you to persist. I want you to persist in that discovering yourself. Don't discover yourself today and tomorrow you relax. Keep discovering yourself. Keep discovering yourself. Keep knowing yourself. Keep knowing who you are. Keep knowing what your father wants you to do. Keep knowing what is the mind of God. Keep knowing what you are called out to do. the ego kept on, was doing that. They were mocking, the ego would fall down, laugh, no, gradually the man, the ego kept on, until one day, the ego flew. They thought it was going to fall. It was going, and they were saying, they gathered together, come and see, don't mind me, it will fall down, this hot sun, don't mind me, it's going to fall down. And later the winds came, the wind of life came. Little did they know that the ego, God has fashioned the ego to sort of soar. Even in the midst of trouble, the ego pulled the wind and relaxed. And the wind that was meant to swallow ego began to push the ego. And the bird that were from down looking at the ego saying, it will fall now. It's going to fall very soon. Don't worry, we will see your fall now. Great will be your fall. They saw the ego and later they did not see him. Praise the Lord. What am I trying to say? Each day, anytime you discover yourself, you fly away like an ego from the net of ignorance, from the association of ignorance. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I know God is talking to us.
Amen.
Anytime you discover yourself, your wings are open. Listen, you are no more like this, but you are not like this. Your wings are open. And when the world is looking at you and saying, this trouble is going to swallow this world now, then you will not look at yourself and say, no, I am trained to overshadow. Then you open your wings. And when you open your wings, the wind is blowing mysteriously. Then God will come in and make you swear in the wings of the Spirit. Just discover yourself. We want to help others. We are called out to help others. But we must discover ourselves. What about when somebody comes to you and says, man, before this woman on the mission came up, God has made me, placed me in the place to counsel and counsel. There are times when people will be talking and will be crying. When I finish, I say, God, is this how I will just end my life? I will just cry. The person has finished talking with me has gone. Me, I will sit down begin to lament. Ha! What kind of person am I? The one has told me he's all and gone. He lived himself. Me, I'm not carrying the burden of my heart. I want to die. God, what kind of thing is this? And until I discover that there is an ability in my inside that for me to hear and hand it over to God.
Yeah.
Not to put it in my heart and start killing myself. Praise Master Jesus. Because the work has not started. The work has not started. We are just doing the handles now. It has not started. So before the work starts now, I will just die before you. See God help me. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
When you discover yourself as a woman, you see that wherever you find yourself, the purpose of God gains expression. You spread out your wings like an eagle. Storms comes, everything comes. You fly away. Even in the hot sun, you gaze at the hot sun because God has placed a lens on you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. I want to tell you another story about an elephant. This elephant, you know, those people that do cycles, that go to cycles, where you take your children, use elephant to make some display. Praise the Lord. This elephant from the tender age was caught. And there's a tiny chain on his leg that they use in tying him to a stick. So the elephant is always there. You know, push less small, can't move. Push less small, can't move. And this elephant was with this man for years. The elephant grew so big, was still being tied in the same stick. The elephant died with that same tiny chain. Why? Because he never chose to discover himself. Though he knew he was big in the inside, in the outside, he never knew he had a big strength in the inside. Because he was used to stay here, don't move. And he died there without moving. No, don't die there without moving. Don't die there without making impact. When you try, you are not getting up. Keep trying. As you are trying, don't try by your own strength. But ask God for strength to try and travel through. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And that elephant, that big elephant, died old. Because why? He could not, he moved a little and the teacher just dragging back. Oh, I can't tell you. No, this thing is too hard to bear. I can't continue. Lord, if it is said, no, take it over, let it pass over me. And he The elephant looked at it and let this cup go. No. This cup must pass. I did not try. Little did he know there is a greater strength. Woman, when you discover yourself, you know that there is a greater strength in your inside. There are potentials in your inside. There are potentials in your inside that the world is waiting for it to manifest. So I will emulate. I said, if this woman can succeed, what about me? Praise the Lord. My mentor is a missionary here in Europe. She does not work. They don't work. But every now and then she's succeeding. She's moving on with the grace and the strength of God. Every now and then she demonstrates faith. Every now and then I see her, she tells me, my daughter, this is how it is. I tell you, there are times there are nothing physically best. She will just tell me it's going to be like this. I think I said before about my first book. I'm not reading chapter one. I've not had chapter one. Page, I'll say this is chapter one. What she told me, I dedicated it on the 29th of April. And she said it, that was how it came out. And she told me that deep down, this is my spirit, I love them. Because I know myself. I don't know where I've gone to. But she spoke the word. And it came to pass. Why? Because she has discovered there is a giant in her inside. It's not her that makes the word to come to pass. It's God. So woman, when you discover yourself, the same thing I've come to tell you, when you discover yourself, you will know it's not you that does the work. It is God that does the work. So me today, I only make an announcement. Say, people come. And the ones that are here are such that will be saved. So you that are here, discover yourself. You are in Pamplona for a reason. I've been in Pamplona for years. To be precise, this is my sixth year. 2018. I've been here for a reason. I've been here for times. Mama said, busy doing what? Nothing. Busy doing nothing. You are just, today you are there. You are here. You are jack of all trades, master of none. You don't even have anything. You are not doing anything. What do people see about you? What will they say about you? What do you have to offer the group around you? People that have known you calling God, what do they have to say about you? Woman, you are on a mission. In Pamplona, you are on a mission. And this mission is not only remaining in Pamplona, it's going wide. Continent is crossing. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I have come to tell us today. Discover yourself. The ego discovered himself and separated from the hands. When you discover yourself, you will be separated from wrong association. You will be separated. But the elephant refused to discover itself and died where it was. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Died where it was. May we not be foolish women in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May we not be foolish women in Jesus'
name. Amen.
May we be women that will make God proud in the name of Jesus.
Oh, yes.
Now God will see us and say, in this land of Pamplona, look at, we call people, I made announcements. I did video, I did everything, but these are the few that came. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
May we be women that makes impact.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
With this, I will round up. Woman, you must know what is in your inside. You must know what is in your inside. You must know that the world wants to know you and they want to see you display your father's character. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You must know what is in your inside so you can be able to offer. It's what somebody has in people. My blessing, what you don't have, you can't give to someone. So it is what you have, you give. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You must know yourself before you help others. You must know yourself before you help others. You must understand your duties. Your duties. I must understand my duties. I must know myself. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I must understand my duties. What does God want me to do? Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And you must understand that you are a compliment. So anywhere you go as a woman, you are to compliment your husband. If you are married, you are to compliment. You are to add flavor. You know when you dress up, some of us will go to the mirror and rub powder to do the finished touch. When you finish wearing, you put your compliment, your necklace and everything so you look good. You are to add goodness to wherever you enter. You are to add flavor to wherever you enter. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said that now you must know and tell yourself, planet a good thing. But not all women are wife. Praise the Lord, sorry. I'm a woman, not all women are wife.
Not all wife.
Okay, so I'm a knife. Okay, God bless you. He said, God, he said some women are knife and some are wives. And the Bible says, he that findeth a wife. Let me define that word, a wife, to my own understanding. A wife is a woman that discovers herself and not the mind of God concerning her life and what she is expected to do for God in that home. He said, and findeth a good thing. So you will judge if you are a wife or you are a knife. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He says, you are a good thing and you are God's favor to this environment. Praise the Lord. So don't let anybody tell you you are a bad thing. Don't let anybody tell you you are good for nothing. Don't let anybody tell you you will not amount to anything. Not even the devil from the pit of hell tell you what you are not. Discover yourself. These are some of the things we can know about ourselves. So I will be able to make you part. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Shall we just stand on our feet and say, God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. We give you glory. We give you